Hello everyone and welcome to the Imperix ACG SDK Getting Started Guide. This guide is composed of three parts. The first will be about making the Simulink model of the converter and its control, the second about simulating the whole model, and the third about generating code to run the control on an Imperix controller. Imperix offers two software development kits to generate real-time control software for its controllers, ACG SDK and C++ SDK. At the end of this video, you will be able to implement your first Simulink model with ACG SDK. A simple control of the output voltage of a buck converter will be considered in this video. To do so, we will apply a PWM signal to the switch with a duty cycle D, equal to the output voltage reference divided by the measured input voltage. This is a very simple feedforward control, whose dynamics will mainly depend on the circuit parameters, but it will still point out many fundamental aspects of closed-loop control, which is the purpose of this video. So, let's get started! To start working with Simulink, it is recommended to start from the template file. The template file is located in the installation folder of ACG SDK. If you haven't installed ACG SDK yet, you should do it first. The template file can be copied and pasted into any working folder and renamed. The template already contains the configuration for the automated generation, upload, and loading of the runtime executable. The template model contains two subsystems. The one on the right contains the plant model, whereas the one on the left the control implementation, which will be later run on an Imperix controller. When the model is built to generate code, the content of the plant model is ignored, and the PWM and measurement signals are replaced by real-world values sampled by the real controller. Let's start by drawing the buck converter model. For this video, the Simscape electrical library is used. To build the converter topology, all you need is a DC source, a chopper leg, and passive load components. Voltage and current probes are used to measure voltage and current and send feedback to the controller. These will be the outputs of the plant subsystem. On the input side, only the firing signal for the upper and lower switches is needed. Then, to make the simulation a bit more interesting and observe the dynamic behavior of the system, a step change in the input voltage and a load step at different instants can be simulated. Finally, the load parameters can be changed to match the one available in a real lab. That's all for the plant design. The input and outputs of the subsystem can now be connected. Let's now switch to the control implementation. The control subsystem already contains the configuration block, a mandatory block from the Imperix blockset, and the inputs and outputs connected to the plant model just created. The configuration block is where the frequency of clock 0 is defined. This clock is used to trigger the ADC sampling and the execution of the main interrupt, and it can also serve as a time base for a PWM generator. This means that, in most applications, the frequency of clock 0 will define the sampling, control, and switching frequencies. To display all the available blocks of the Imperix library, press Ctrl-L when the configuration block is selected. The Simulink blockset included in ACG SDK enables graphical converter control software design and implementation to make Imperix controllers directly programmable from Simulink. Therefore, the same Simulink model can be used for offline simulation and experimental testing. This makes the transition from simulation to real power the smoothest possible. One crucial block from the Imperix library is the ADC block. This block is used to retrieve the value of the measurements. In this simulation, three ADC blocks are needed, one for each measurement. All the blocks can be dragged and dropped from the Imperix library to the Simulink model. The simulation input of the ADC blocks has to be connected to the control inputs, which contain the simulated values of the measurements. Following the same order of the measurements retrieved from the plant subsystem, the first measurement is the output voltage, the second the input voltage, and the third the inductor current. Next, let's connect the ADC clock of the configuration block to all the ADC blocks to transmit the sampling frequency. A probe block with a user-defined name can be connected to each measurement signal to log the values of the measurements when the code runs on a real controller. This way, the probed variables will be available on our real-time monitoring software cockpit, which will be shown in the third video. Now let's add a tunable parameter block to define the output voltage reference. The advantage of using a tunable parameter is that the corresponding created variable can be watched and altered in real time using Cockpit. To test the reference tracking of this control, an output voltage reference step can be defined in the tunable parameter block. Let's give the variable a coherent name, for instance VoutRef, and set its initial value to 12 volts. By clicking on Steps in the Simulation tab, a voltage reference step from 12 volts to 20 volts at 75 milliseconds can be defined. Then, this reference can be divided by the measured input voltage to get the duty cycle value. Finally, a modulator is needed to generate the firing signal of the converter switch. Several modulators are provided in the Imperix library to fulfill the needs of a wide range of applications, whether for a traditional carrier-based or a more advanced multi-level modulator. In this case, a carrier-based modulator is chosen. The clock input of the modulator can be connected to the PWM clock of the configuration block to define its switching frequency to clock zero frequency, which is set as default to 20 kHz. To finish, the output of the modulator has to be connected to the output of the control subsystem, which is, in turn, connected to the gate of the transistor in the plant subsystem. Our whole model is now ready to be simulated. This is the scope of the next video.